Dear Arthur, I've written this letter 100 times or more, and I cannot get it right. It's me. You know it's me from the bad handwriting. I know I said when we last spoke, and I was going off to get married, that we would not speak again. I know I said a lot of things, and I meant them, I suppose, at the time. But I'm not so proud as to not speak to people who care for me, or cared for me. I've been in Valentine for a couple of months. I had some bad luck, and, well, it's a long story and not an interesting one. But I am here for now. I saw a couple of the girls, or whatever the polite term is for them, that ran with you and your associates in town. And I heard tell of a man who sounded like you. I would love to see you again, if you could spare me a little bit of your time. I'm renting a room at Chadwick Farm, just north of Valentine. Yours, Mary Linton.
Arthur.
Think you're losing your touch. How so?
Evening.
Yeah.
No.
I think you think I wanted that snake to bite me.
I think it's awful convenient, is all.
Oh, hey, friend! Remember me? I won't bite.
Hey,
Wallace, this here's the kind soul I was telling you about.
The one that, got the venom out of your leg?
Guess so.
Listen, friend, I know I can never repay you, but how about you head over to the gunsmith and pick out your choice of item on my tab?
Oh, well, thanks.
Yeah, seemed like the least I could do with him being sent straight from the Almighty to save my life.
Yeah, the Almighty.
Always a doubter, you are.
I'm a man of this world, not the next one.
Outside told me I could grab something on his tab. One with the bite in his leg.
Ah, Norbert, huh? Well, he's good for it. About all he's good for between the two of us. Well, take a look around. Find something you like, I'll put it on his tab. Fine choice. I'll let him know. Bye now.
Howdy.
After before, I'm sure wary of you. Welcome back. Can I get a room, please?
Room's all yours. Head on up.
Thanks.
Morning.
Let's go, boy.
Yeah, how you making out?
Good morning to you.
Hey, what the hell?
Yes?
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to disturb you, ma'am. Is Mrs. Linton in?
I'll go see.
Mrs. Linton, a caller for you.
Hello, Arthur. I heard you and your friends was around.
Okay. Where's what's his name?
Died.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, me too. Happened a while ago. Pneumonia.
Bad business.
Sure.
So, you've been... you've been made a widow and... You come here looking for me, is that it?
No, ain't like that, Arthur.
Oh, okay.
Listen, Arthur, I'm... My family. I need your help.
You mean the family that always looked down on me? And you want me to help?
It's my little brother, Jamie.
I always liked Jamie, at least compared to the rest of them.
He's broken Daddy's heart.
Daddy has a heart?
Don't make me beg you, Arthur.
My money, my life, me. I wasn't good enough.
I'm sorry. We need your help real bad. Little Jamie's joined the Chelonians, that strange religious order.
Good for him.
They're quite mad, Arthur. They'll kill him. You're the only person he'd listen to.
So, I'm too rough to marry into your family, but it's okay to ask me to help in saving your family.
I'm sorry. I understand if you don't want to help me, but I think of you often.
Long time ago now.
I'm begging you, Arthur.
I say let Jamie live Jamie's life and not the nightmare that his daddy dreamed up for him.
Jamie's so innocent, Arthur. Please, Arthur. Will you help me?
Where is it?
Somewhere out near Carmody Dell, I think. The rancher there said he'd seen him around the Cumberland Forest. I just want him back, Arthur. If you find him, bring him to me at the station.
I'll see what I can do.
I'll owe you.
You already owe me. Come on, pal.
Thank you.
You all right, boy?
Mister! Help!
Hey, shut up.
Get out of here. Act like you never saw this.
Slow it up.
Come on. We made out all right.
Jesus Christ!
Come on now, boy.
Cassidy is not old Crazy Man Cassidy.
Darn. Darn people.
seek redemption all. It's never too late. Help a blind man.
Okay, sure.
You didn't run when last we spoke, sir. You didn't run far enough.
All right. Well, I'll have to take your word for it. Hey, boy. Thank you.
Thank you. That's a nice looking horse you have there. Hold on a minute now. We're talking to you.
Head's still rolling from the roof.
All right, no problem. No harm in asking.
And rediscovery of theology.
Gentlemen!
Shell of safety.
Can I speak to the boy?
Arthur?
Hello, son. Your sister is very worried.
The boy has chosen a path, sir. Path to truth.
Well, his sister just wants to speak with him.
Arthur, I've chosen a path.
The boy has chosen a path. He's chosen safety. What path have you chosen, sir?
I don't know about this nonsense. Let me speak to the boy.
Dut-dut. Are you always this negative and antagonistic, sir?
I'm not a very cultured man. Forgive me, please.
I am a fool for my God and a happy one, sir. I bless you. What do I dream about? Who are my heroes?
I have no idea. Turtles. Yeah, turtles. Hey, you love turtles? I love them too. Turtles.
Jamie knows the truth, but of course, you may speak with him.
Exactly. If your teachings are so great, what harm can I do?
I'm not coming with you, Arthur!
Just come and speak with Mary, then make up your mind!
She'll hold
Leave
you.
Me alone, Arthur! I didn't ask for your help! Arthur Morgan! Leave me alone!
Please, kid. Put that gun down.
I warn you, Arthur! I'm gonna... I don't want to live anymore!
Kid, just calm down.
Leave me alone!
Calm down! Let's go see your sister.
Okay. Okay.
It's okay, kid.
Have I been a terrible fool, Arthur?
I don't know. I don't know enough about it. But one thing I do know. There ain't no shame in looking for a better world.
I missed you, Arthur. Are you and Mary sweet on one another again?
Oh, no. That's all a long time ago, son. You idiot.
Well, this wasn't how I thought today would turn out.
It's been a long time, Jamie Gillis. You were a kid last time I saw you. Didn't try to kill yourself.
You know, you taught me how to ride a horse.
Too well, apparently. Shalonia, though? Really? You'd fall for that?
They were very nice to me. They're decent.
I'm sure. Please tell me you didn't give them any money.
Of course I did. They rely on charitable donations.
Jesus, Jamie, come on.
I just wanted to believe that there might be something good coming my way one day. Guess that's dead in the water.
With the turtles.
Shut up. All Father kept telling me was, you won't amount to anything. You're not enough of a man. I had to get away. I couldn't take it anymore.
Forgive me, but your father's a bully and a coward. Don't listen to him.
Hey, don't talk about him like that.
What do you want me to say, Jamie? He's a good father, a nice man.
He won't be happy I saw you.
Please send him my worst regards.
The thing is, he's right. I'm not good at anything.
Come on, That ain't true. Tell me something you like. Don't think too hard.
Apples, I guess.
Apples?
Yeah, I love apples.
Okay. I was thinking more along the lines of carpentry or horses or something, but all right, go work in an orchard then.
By that token, you must really like shooting and robbing people.
I only like shooting young idiots who run away from me when I'm trying to help them.
Father told me what you do.
I'm sure he did.
Hey, are you still with Dutch and what was his name? Hester?
Jose. Yep, still the same, sort of.
And Annabelle and Bessie?
I'm afraid they're dead.
Shit. Maybe Mary did make the right choice.
No doubt. But none of it is anything like the nonsense you read in the newspapers.
So, are you two getting back together?
I told you, no. Just ask me for a favor.
You know Barry Lyndon's dead? Pneumonia.
She told me.
So the door's open, so to speak.
That's all in the past. Different people now.
She's not. And you seem just the same.
Well, maybe that right there's a problem. She was always too good for me. Now, let's just get you back to your sister. She's waiting at the station for us. Here we are. She must be waiting inside.
You're nervous about seeing her, aren't you? Make it quick or I might run off again.
Father's been very sad.
Father wouldn't know sadness if it died in his bed. But I'll come home for you.
My boy. My sweet boy. Come on. Oh, Arthur. Thank you. Thank you.
It's good to see you, Mary.
And you, Arthur. And you. Oh, you'll never change. I know that.
I feel like the luckiest man alive, and I feel like a fool. That woman confuses me and plays me for a fiddle like no one else alive. I trust I will not make a god-awful fool of myself once more, but somehow I imagine I shall.
do you?
Howdy.
What?
Getting quick, folks, before I eat all these chops myself.
It's me!
Welcome back.
Evening, Arthur.
Put on some warmer clothes, friend.
So you brought the loudmouth kid back to us.
I'm sorry. I wanted them to hang him.
Well, he amuses me. You done good, Arthur. Loyalty.
I made it as far as Chicago, Miss Jackson. Chicago ain't nowhere near Australia. No, but it's on the way. I always wanted to see one.
Bring me something soon if you can, Arthur.
I will.
Okay, sweetheart.
Interesting way of seeing things.
Thank you, Arthur.
We'll get over there one of these days, huh?
Yeah. Evening.
Starting nice to see you, lady.
Kangaroo farmers. Well, there's a dream we ain't had yet.
Hey, how have you been, Arthur?
Fine. I'm real sorry, but I can't talk right now.
Okay, then. Not to worry.